This ball is crushed.
What's going on, everyone? Coach Austin here with Ragin Cages. And today we're going to bring you a drill called flat ground and sets. I use this one a lot with almost every single one of my lessons, and it's a good one because it can be used regardless of age. There's really no age restriction to it. The purpose behind this is to get our body moving the correct way when it comes to the pitching side. If you're not a pitcher, this is also a good drill for just throwing mechanics in general. So what you're going to do is all you need is their glove and a ball, and they're going to set about 25 feet away from their target. And we're going to start on a knee. If they're right-handed, they're on their right knee. If they're left-handed, they're on their left knee. To start out, the front leg should be toe forward and at 90 degrees. We do not want it less, and we don't want it more. Okay? Right at 90. Same thing with this back leg. We should create a 90-degree angle, and our knee should be facing our target. This back knee and this back side gives us direction and where we throw the baseball, so we need to make sure that's directed towards our target. Not here and not open. From there, the upper half of the body. The front side with the glove, we want pointed at our target and firm. Okay? If you need help remembering that as well, that should also create somewhat of a 90-degree angle. Same thing with the back. Get it up at 90 and the ball facing away from us. Okay? This is our setup. From here to throw, all they're going to do is rotate, bring that glove into their chest, turn, throw, and follow through with their chest to their knee. It's a good tip to remember that the knee should not come forward with them as they throw. It stays put. Only thing that's rotating is the upper half following through chest to the knee. Okay? After you do a few of those, then you start them with their hands together at their heart. Now they're going to break and throw all one motion. Now we're adding a little rhythm to it. Okay? Those can be done 10, 15 reps at a time. Once they fully do that, then you get them on their feet and you move them back about 15 to 20 feet. From here, now they're going to set up in a landing position as if they already landed. Okay? Back foot, they should be on their toe with their heel up off the ground, facing directly behind them. Same thing, toe pointed forward or slightly closed. Okay? From here, the upper half is the same setup. 90-90, ball facing away. Okay? From here, they can get a little rhythm if they want and rock back, but all they're going to do is rock back. Same thing as the knee. Rotate, reach, throw, follow through. The back foot does not leave the ground. Okay? Neither of our feet leave the ground this drill. We stay put. Okay? So again, set up, rock back, rotate, reach, and throw. Same thing as the knee. After you do a few of those, hands at the heart. Now you're going to rock back, separate, and throw all one motion. Okay? This foot is key because that gets the hip in the direction that we're working with, and it allows us to find that good separation that we want when we throw and we pitch. We want the hips forward and the chest back. Okay? This is a very good drill that I use with all of my lessons. The good thing, like I said, is there's no age limit. If they're having trouble pitching or throwing, this can be used as a training tool. If you're an older kid and you're pretty developed, this should be more of a warm-up leading into your pitching. Okay? From day one to the last day that I played, I used this as a warm-up. I did it every day, every single day before I got on the mound or before I played catch. Okay? You're going to see good results, okay? It's going to take a while because you're trying to beat a bad habit, but this can be done every single day in the backyard or at a game or before practice. If you stick with it and stick with it, you'll see that transformation. And as always, continue to work while you wait.